So therefore, at least we should be in sattva guna. That is like firm footing to remain in the sattva guna. And from sattva guna, we can transcend to the visuddha sattva. So in our dealings, in our lifestyle, in our eating habits, in our practicing, in our surrounding, everything, if we are maintaining the mode of goodness, then our consciousness is very pure. And in that consciousness, if we are practicing spirituality, then it becomes quite easy to go to the nirguna platform, slowly, slowly. And bhakti is the powerful process. What is that verse? So in Gita, they say that one who practices bhakti, he can transcend the modes. Mam cho vyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samatittetam brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So, at least one has to come to the platform of goodness. Wonderful graphical example given by Srila Prabhupada is that coming to the airport. Many times we hear. Let us discuss this example. If we want to take a flight, what should we do? Go to the roof and try to climb the flight. Climb up to helicopter or catch the flight like this? No. For that, at least we have to go to the airport. Okay? And just by going to the airport, we cannot catch the flight or go to Mumbai. We have to get the boarding pass or buy a ticket. Right? And then only we can board in the flight to go to Mumbai or any other city. And another thing is that in the airport, there are some persons who are not passengers. They are also there in the airport. And they don't go and board in the flight and go to the other city. Like, for example, who are they? The staffs, the security staffs, the officers. There are many people, those who are working in that particular place, airlines. So they are there, they are just roaming here and there. And also some relatives also come to drop us. They are also there. But everyone is not boarding in the flight. Only who has the ticket, he can board in the flight. Let us extend this analogy furthermore. If sometimes some natural calamity happens or some terrorist attack, the government flight comes, helicopter, and they rescue the people from the particular place, just like we had a pralaya disaster in 2013 in Kedarnath. So many devotees were also there. And then from Indian Army, the flight came and they rescued the people. And they landed in Delhi without any cost. No boarding pass is required, no ticket. All cost belongs to the Indian government. Anything, such things happens. So that also is one consideration, that people go to different places. So this is compared to, like this, four different stages. The airport is compared to the mode of goodness. At least one has to be in the mode of goodness. And the second is that the one has to buy the ticket or get the boarding pass is like practicing devotional service, chanting Hare Krishna. So one has to practice. Just in remaining in the goodness is not enough to transcend the modes. One has to practice. And that is like buying the ticket. You're getting, you are with me. So that is like getting the ticket. And then third is that there are some persons who are like security staffs and ground staffs and officers and some relatives comes. They are also in the mode of goodness. They are also in the airport, but they don't board the flight. So that is like sattuguna. They are in sattuguna, but they cannot transcend the gunas. They are just remaining in the. And another thing I forgot. Sometimes the security staffs or the officers, because of some reason, they get demotion or they get transferred to other place. Now this is security of that particular, and he will go to some factory. There he will do his service, or some demotion happen. Demotion, you understand? No? Like that. So that is compared to one who is always one who is in goodness. In the material world, goodness is misra sattvagun. Is any time the lower modes can affect the passion and ignorance. It's like the person transfer or go to another place for the service. He was demotion happens, and not the promotion. So this is like the person who gets transferred. And then, as I said, the during some calamities or some terrorist attack, the government plane comes and they rescue the persons. And someone may say, oh, the plane came and they rescued the 10 people and they took them to Delhi or some other place. They are not taking me. I also want to go. Someone may ask. No, for that you have to go to the airport, buy a ticket and then go to Delhi or Mumbai. That was the exceptional case. If someone is like in very lower modes and immediately transcend to the nirguna platform, that is very, very rare and extreme case. It's like Mahat Kripa. Government plane comes and rescues him. He doesn't rescue the whole citizen of the country. That is very rare case. So the point is that we have to come to we have to be at least in the mode of goodness, and then slowly transcend the modes.